This is a swarm of a drone taking off altogether. They are controlled using ROS2 in real time. And these virtual robots on the web not only can communicate with your Python code, but also it is debuggable using its built-in console terminal. If you are a serious robotics engineer or student, stop wasting your time using the simulation made for kids robotics program, which is great. However, it may be too simple for you. So let me walk through this with you. Alright, Ubicurus, this is Elliot. Today, I'm going to share how you can start testing your ideas of swarm of drones using ROS in a most simplistic way. And especially if you are just starting out your robotics journey, I highly recommend this virtual robots on the web because it's so simple. You don't waste any time. The story is like this. When I was in grad school, I was looking for something really simple, robotics simulation. At the time, whenever I searched it, it's made for kids robotics program, which is great. However, it was a little too simple for me as a graduate student. Otherwise, I have to install this and that. And then usually even the build process ended up with a lot of errors. And I had to spend several days to configure all these to eventually start testing my simple idea. So today I'm going to share a most simple configurable swarm of drone simulation on the web if you are familiar with the web browser and ROS. So if you have never heard about ROS, it's perfect time to be aware of it. First of all, ROS stands for Robot Operating System, and it has nothing to do with the actual operating system because it is not an operating system. Instead, it's more like a bunch of packages with libraries that you can include in your C++ or Python packages. And it's based on Linux system, and it has some handy commands on the Ubuntu terminal. Eventually, you'd want to use ROS because you can write different applications with different languages like C++ and Python, and then let them share the information. What do I mean by that? For instance, let's say I want to make an autonomous drone that can recognize human body gesture and takeoff and landing by itself. I can write an AI or computer vision algorithm in Python, saying using PyTorch. Also, you could write a C++ program that controls motor driver in real time. However, as these apps are written in different languages, they can't natively share the variables. Instead, using TCP or UDP sockets, they can share the information. It's like the two applications automatically chatting with each other. By the way, this kind of network implementation is always possible even without using ROS. If you are maybe coming from backend server engineering, this is trivial in a way. If your project is small enough that you can write a single Python script and then it can be done, you don't want to overcomplicate your project using ROS. However, if you are using multiple applications with different languages to drive all these different motors and hardware and so on, you might want to use ROS because your robot probably needs to share a lot of information like positions and velocity, GPS sensor values in real time, like 100 times per second or 400 times per second. And then ROS comes really handy, extremely handy, so that you can reduce your development time and get more sleep. All right, I think that's enough talking. So let's actually get down to the actual business. This is the virtual robot website, and I'll put the link down in the description section or in the comment section so that you can duplicate what I'm doing here. And then to begin with, after you connect this URL, go to one of multi-rotor or high control helicopter. Actually, the only difference is that one is in the night city scene and another one is daytime scene. So choose whatever you prefer. And for now, I'm going to choose the daytime city. Actually, let me increase this web browser a little bit. And if you really want, you can click this full screen mod. And this, my screen capture here is not really capturing my entire monitor, but it is actually a full screen now. But anyway, for the sake of recording, let me just like this. And then the secret is here, like terminal, toggle terminal, or press control tilde, and then this terminal will come up. And then the first thing I'm gonna do is just remove all the default free robots. Then it's gone. Then I'm going to load default mission, load mission load, just type tap, then it will autocomplete the command, and then type enter. And then let's change the view a little bit. Go to assistant view 2. And then there are three drones like this. And then if you really want to control this manually, you can just turn on the manual button and then just toggle up and down for the throttles. So this is your basic setup for this swarm of drones. Now, where is the code? I'll also put this link in the description section, and then let's follow this RS2 part. So first thing I would do is just copy paste this one. If you have Docker installed, I'm assuming you are using Docker, and then if you never used Docker before, I will put another link about the Docker. For now, let's keep moving on. So this is my VS Code, and this is my Docker Compose. I just copy pasted here, and then just what you need to do is just run this Docker Compose. And then I'll go to here, attach a Visual Studio code. Then for now, I'm just going to close this one. Then I have entire Ubuntu operating system is Ubuntu 20, 22. And we are in this Ubuntu system with ROS installed on it. So the next step is cloning a couple of projects, the default project for this connection. So I'm just going to copy paste this, go over here, and under SRC, I'm going to open up a new terminal. Then just run all these three commands. Then it will just automatically git clone all these git repos, and we are ready to go. The next thing I'm going to do is just build this cd dot. So this is my default workspace, and to build it, just type cocon build. Yeah, so let's just copy paste this step. So cocon build dash symlink install, and it will build all the packages that is necessary. So meantime, let me talk about this diagram here. So this is the virtual robot on the web like this. And then this virtual robot is communicating with this RS Humble. And then inside of this instance, this bridge module is actually communicating with this simulation. And then this module is doing its own thing by itself. And that is here, the bridge component. And then it's more like a boil template code. You don't have to really worry too much about all of this. What it is doing is just simply packing and unpacking all the messages from this website. So that's all. And then the actual thing that we really want to focus is this swarm package. So let's go to RS2 VR swarm. And then if I turn on my VR node, I forgot something. So there is no ubiquitous vrobots packages. And that's because I forgot to install the Python packages for this. If I go up here, there's a PIP install, just the necessary packages for Python. So let's just copy paste and then install this. So this is just a typical RS node script. And then in this script, I'm just defining the parameter for this node, which is system ID. And system ID is important because we need to control each of the robots. And when we send a message, we want to send a message to the specific virtual robot. And that's why we need the system ID. And then system ID is by default defined as 0, but it will get the new parameters when it starts. And then it defines a subscriber, and a subscriber is more like receiving the messages from other nodes like bridge node. And then whenever the bridge publishes new message, like state messages, like position and velocity for each drone, and it will just subscribe that information and then do whatever calculation it needs. So I'm just creating a subscriber here. And then vrobot states is just a one of the message type. And then it's just the name of the message for our system. And this is a self.controller, which is a callback function, which will be called here. And then 10 is called for the quality of service. And that literally means I'm going to store 10 data points. If the communication is lost, we'll restore from the previous 10 steps. And then the publisher is defined here. It's just the name of the publisher. And then we are passing the name of the publisher here. And there's just message type. Vrobot, virtual robot commands, and then same QoS profile. And then we are defining finally the control algorithm here. And then the controller subscribe the state messages like my vertical position, like altitude and velocity. And then based on this current position, it will calculate all these AI altitude control algorithm. and then it will eventually calculate the throttle of this drone and then publish the command message to control this throttle to this relation like this. So if I publish 1,500 something, it will have this throttle specifically. That's why I'm defining this throttle here in the code. And then there is a launch file. This launch file is running this node for how many times defined here? 4 times, right? So for now, we have only 3 drones. Let's change it to 3. And then that's it. So it is passing parameter here as a system ID, and then it just increases from 0 to 0, 1, 2, right? Anyway, that's the RS script. Finally, let's just run this. I'm just going to open up the terminal and clear all that. And first thing I'm going to run is running this bridge here. I need to run this bridge node. Make sure that you are at your workspace, and then I will source this because I have already built it. Source install slash setup the bash. Let's just copy paste the code here to run the bridge. This one. Yeah, that's the right command. Then this bridge is running. Now I'll go back here and I'll just simply connect. Then you have a green light, which means it's connected with this RS. The next thing I'm going to run this swarm. I'm going to copy paste this. It's actually this part. This command, and then in a new terminal, I'll do source install setup the bash again. It means in this specific terminal, this terminal is not by default aware of this install setup the bash file. So you just need to let this terminal aware of all these variables within this install that setup the bash file. Then to run this finally, I'll run this. Now let me go back to the website, and then all of a sudden all these 3 drones are flying, and that is stopping at around 220 meters, I believe. And then rest of them are floating away because this attitude control is not really specified. Now let's change the set point to, I don't know, 25 meters. Hey guys, this is Elliot. If you find this video helpful, please like, share, subscribe for more tutorials and tips on robotics engineering. Or 55 meters, I don't know, just because. I'll stop this launch command, and then I'll run this again at 55 meters above the ground. So if I go back here, now they are ascending all together. And then if I toggle here, if I go to states, it's about negative 55, and that's because the Z direction in this simulation is towards downwards, so going up is negative direction. If you want to see a more holistic view, toggle this fly camera, free camera here, then you are looking at these 3 drones floating as a formation, default formation like this, and then you can test all these control algorithms for testing the swarm of drones and robots all together. And there are helicopters and car and so on, so you don't have to bind yourself into the drone simulation like this. But anyway, with this virtual robot environment, you can quickly get started and test your own ideas for multiple robots all together. All you need is just a web browser and ROS2 and Python. So I think it's really simple setup, and then you can really test and collect the data if you are a researcher for this field. I highly recommend to try out this simulation. And especially if you're a beginner, don't let other unnecessary installation steps bother your journey of starting up your own robotics project, because you deserve more than that. If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching.